Hi, this is Kurt with Traverse Tool Company. Today we have a special guest, Dustin Maben, who is the owner of Maben's Concepts, and he's going to show you how to polish aluminum today.
All right, so we're going to brush finish this part. We're going to start with some sandpaper. I'm using the Merca auto net paper. It works well because it takes WD-40 really well, so I can saturate this sandpaper, get it loaded with WD-40 and coat the part. Now I've got good lubrication, I'm not sanding dry. That's a pretty key principle for the sanding part of it. Safety-wise, this is obviously inherently a dangerous operation to begin with because your hands are going to be on near a chuck and that's rotating. The key thing for the safety is to make sure that you're sanding on the plane of the part, that if the sandpaper was to grab, it will grab and throw out towards your body and not in toward the lathe. That is the very, very critical step in doing this on a lathe. You do not want to be using your sandpaper in a direction that is possible to pull the sandpaper and your arm into the machine. You want to use it where if it grabs, it kicks it out towards you. And it doesn't take much. That should be good for the bulk of the sanding. It's a pretty quick process. The part was pretty slick off the mill. It's not too bad, so that's good enough for the 180. Now the next step. Pretty short on that end too. It's a pretty fast process typically, so that's enough for the red Scotch-Brite. Getting close to having the finish that we want. Now we'll finish it with the gray Scotch-Brite. WD-40 again. And that's it. You should be done and your part should have a brush finish. It's a really natural look for aluminum. I like it for the car parts that we build here. A customer doesn't have to keep up with a polished finish, so it's not as labor intensive on the maintenance on their end, and still is a really professional looking, to me more of a classy finish than a polished part. So. A couple things that I want to mention again on the safety thing, just to reiterate it again, make sure that you're using the cloth or the sandpaper, whatever, in the direction where if it grabs, it'll throw it out toward you. This is key safety. If you value your arms, this is the most important. Another key thing is no gloves. Don't wear gloves. If you don't like the feel of WD-40 on your hands, this is not an operation for you. A glove is something else to get caught up and wound up in this chuck. So you want to come in here bare hands and on the top or in the direction, if you will, so they will throw it off. I had this machine spinning toward me this way. which is why I had my cloth on the top. That way it'll throw it toward me. If I was spinning the machine this way, then I would need to have it on the bottom, because that was when it would throw it toward me. So depending on which way you have your machine spinning, depends on whether you want it top or bottom. The key factor is it throws your arm or your cloth out towards your body and not in toward the machine. And lastly, a huge mistake that I see a lot of people make, they clean it while it's running. That is a huge no-no. Stop the machine, then clean it. If you get in a bad habit of cleaning it while you're running, sooner or later you're going to wrap around it, not thinking, and it's going to grab, and catastrophic damage can be done. So avoid that, stop the machine, then wipe your part off. That's the biggest safety things that I can throw out there. Other than that, it's a great trick to turn up, you know, a rough part right off of CNC into a smooth part in just a few minutes work. I like to run the machine at a faster RPM. The sandpaper and the Scotch-Brite seem to grab a lot less, faster than slower. So that's why I was running 765 RPM there. But that's just because it tends to drag less, therefore it catches less. So that's it. That's that one. All right, we're going to start on this wheel. We're going to use a little brown. Stand off to the side of the part, which for me, the most comfortable, I'm going to have my back to you for this thing. And now we'll go over to the other wheel. Use some red or some white. Just give it the final finish. And again, sky's the limit, but you can see how quick you can polish one up with the buffing wheels and the different compounds, using typically brown to get some of the scratches, and working your way up to white. There's a lot of compounds in between, and you can pretty much put as much time as you wanted into the part, but that's a get you going in the right direction. You get the basic idea. We started with a part that was brush finish off a lathe, and within a few minutes had a polished finish off of a buffing wheel. So there you go.
Well, Dustin, thank you for letting us visit your shop. That was super informative. If you have any other questions about how to polish aluminum or the tools that you use, give us a call or send us an email.